Canberra, Australia's national capital, was built 30 years ago in this valley of the southern tablelands between Melbourne and Sydney. Looking across the city from the northern side is the Australian War Memorial. It was built as a shrine and museum to commemorate those Australians who gave their lives in the First World War. Representations of famous actions in diorama or painting, and interesting relics like this felt scarf, were assembled but barely completed before World War II created a new generation of heroes, a more extensive war history to commemorate. In 1952, the Commonwealth government decided to extend the scope of the memorial to cover all wars in which Australians had taken part. And in this central block, the Hall of Memory, the entire inside wall area will be covered in mosaics, figures and designs to represent the sacrifice of the men and women of the Australian services. Work is going on now. Most of it is done 400 miles away in Melbourne, where the various designs and motifs are drawn to scale, where the dominant figures for each of the four walls are sketched and eventually translated into mosaic form from full-scale cartoons such as this. It's all the work of Napier Waller, veteran of the First World War, a mosaic and stained glass expert who has been commissioned to design and supervise the completion of the Hall of Memory.
Yes. I was working on the Hall of Memory for 4.5 years. First on the stained glass windows, and now on the mosaic. Some of the designs for which you see around here. The whole area of the walls to be covered is about 13,000 square feet, or 5 tennis courts, or in terms of weight, about 18 or 20 tons of mosaic material. The height of each of the connected walls is 40 feet. This figure is 11 feet high and symbolizes the women's services. It may be of interest to know that the model who helped with the figure was an army nursing sister and is now living in Scotland. Among the symbolism which surrounds the figure, you may have noted the sea centaur. Centaur was the name of the torpedo hospital ship in which a number of army nurses lost their lives.
The woman's figure is the only one so far completed and in place in Canberra. Napier Waller is at present working on the figure representing the army. Tracings are taken of the completed cartoon section by section. Mosaic lines are marked on the tracings, following the natural construction lines of the limb as much as possible. And from this tracing, another one, but in reverse, is taken. And on this tracing, glue is applied along the tessera lines, and each individual piece of tessera put face downwards onto the glued paper. All designs are in sections, and when completed, they are sent to Canberra and applied to the walls like this. Waller is using 70 different colours in the same way as a pointillist. Each colour has its own number and is kept in separate boxes. Mosaic sections for parts of the wall which are plain, designs such as in the window panels which are repeated in each bay, are prepared by a staff, all working on the same pattern, and applying the same coloured piece of tessera as it is handed out by a monitor, face downwards onto the paper. These sections will be tapped into soft cement rendering on the walls, and then the paper is washed off to leave the flat face on the outside. As each section is completed, it is packed in boxes ready for dispatch to Canberra. On arrival in Canberra, the sections are spread out in their order. Their numbers are checked against a replica of Napier Waller's plan in Melbourne. And then they are sent up in order to the mosaic craftsmen working above in the gantries. Sections of wall are prepared about 30 square feet at a time with cement. Before the cement rendering has set, a matter of a few minutes, the mosaic section, itself well covered with white cement, is put into position and tapped firmly into place. The two mosaic craftsmen are from Italy, Aldo Rossi and Cavaliere Ufficiale De Marco. But let Mr. De Marco introduce himself.
I was born in Italy, went to England at the early age of my life, learned the trade of Roman mosaic and glass mosaic. During my period in England, I've carried out some big work, including some falls, the feeble downs, also the South Kensington Museum, Roman mosaic floors, and various other contracts in the building trade in London. Then came out to Australia, my early stages, and continuing glass mosaic and all other work which we do, and then finished up coming to Canberra doing the Hall of Memory for the Australian War Memorial. Mr. Aldo Rossi, which I brought out from Italy, is a mosaic expert. He learned his trade in Italy. Besides that, Mr. Aldo Rossi, he has quite a big classification of knowledge of glass mosaic. He's learned his trade in Spilimbergo, which is a school of mosaic in the north of Italy, the only school in Italy of glass mosaic and Roman mosaic. The walls have been rendered with cement. Then, to pick up a mosaic, we've got to put it onto the wall and set it in while the background is still soft. And by us setting it in, we get a level surface on the back where we'll take the paper off. So will you excuse me?
Sure.
Right. Yes.
No.
See that?
No.
Over here, there's a section which is just completed. Then I'll go over and take the paper off. All the pieces are even because they've been stuck on paper. Now is revealed the mosaic of Mr. Major Waller's plan.
What about the
floor,
Mr. Waller? Hello, Mr. Waller.
The floor will be of the light, warm marble. Very much the colour of the walls. There'll be a rather interesting effect of the walls rising almost imperceptibly out of the reflections of the polished surface of the floor. I think the whole of the work of the hall will be finished in about 2 years' time.